Did you know Super Awesome Mix has an app? Go to the Apple App Store today and download Super Awesome Mix. It's free. You could start creating and sending your own digital mixtapes in just a few clicks. Also, there's links to our Instagram account and a link where you can follow your favorite podcast. Speaking of which... Welcome back to another Super Awesome Mix. My name is Matt Sidholm, alongside my co-host and co-founder of Super Awesome Mix, Samer Abusalbi. Samer, how are we doing this week?
I am doing real well, and I am, as always, very excited for today's mix. This one in particular, because, you know, I kind of need some joy in my life, and music can be a really good source of joy, as I've discussed a lot on our Instagram, which if you're not a follower, be sure to follow us at Super Awesome Mix. But yeah, I just kind of felt, you know what, I need like a solid 12 songs of things that are happy. I want the mood to be happy, and I want the lyrics to be happy, so I'm not secretly like bopping my head to something about with something really dark, which, you know, we've covered before on our show. So yeah, this was a fun, like literally a fun mix to put together.
Yeah, really fun. And it's less about getting fired up and more just about kind of feeling good. Like that's really, yeah, I think the vibe we were going for here. And we decided, yeah, and I think we both did a good job of doing it that way, but we decided we're going to present it this week in kind of an A-side, B-side sort of way. So we're going to do all six of Samer's picks to start, and then all six of my picks after that.
Yeah, so similar to how we did our fitness class like a little while back, where we did an A-side, B-side, we might do another competition, because while I totally crushed you on that one, it was 70-30, I think, was the final tally.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah. Those are percentages. Those are percentages, right, by the way, not actual votes, okay?
The votes were way higher. No.
And I think a lot of those were mail-in ballots, okay? There were some questions.
Oh, God. We're doing impersonations now. This show's gone down in its second season. It's just not the same quality as it once was. But no, you know, I think if we did another competition, this would be... I'd be curious, because I think both sides are very strong. I think we both understood the assignment in this case. So
yeah, I don't think either one of us... Yeah, there was very little misunderstanding. So you get off to, I think, a really strong start here. Okay, a little bit of a throwback. You go with Lovely Day by Bill Withers.
Yeah. So as I've mentioned on previous podcasts, there's always one song that I'm like, well, this has to be it, right? Like this sets the theme for everything else. Although in this case, it doesn't really set the theme, because I go in a different direction here in a moment. But let's pretend that that's not true. Because how can you have a joyful mix without Bill Withers singing Lovely Day? He holds that note for 18 seconds, people. 18 seconds. That's incredible. I mean, you listen to it and you feel out of breath listening to him sing it. And of course, he's singing it with a gorgeous voice. And this last year was really the first time that I like began to truly appreciate Bill Withers. I had obviously known a lot of his songs. Funny enough, I didn't realize just how many of his songs that I knew that were his. And I was like, oh my goodness, like that's his song too? Like Lean On Me? Oh, gorgeous. But anyway, Lovely Day, obviously, lyrically is beautiful. Sonically is beautiful. I had to open my mix up with this, even though, like I mentioned, I go a little bit different here in a moment. But also a song from 1977. So another, could have been another great candidate.
That's another
for your birthday
one. Yeah.
Mix. Yeah. Yeah.
It's a great one. No, I love the song. It puts you in a great mood, but it's also kind of mellow, right? Like mm-hmm. I was saying earlier, this isn't about getting fired up, it's about feeling good. And I think this one captures that perfectly. And I think also used really well. So obviously he's talking about it's a lovely day when he's with, you know, his partner, right? Like this person in his life. But this is used at the end of the movie, The Secret Life of Pets. I don't know if you've seen that animated movie, but it's also, you know, people coming home and their pets being so happy to see them and vice versa. So, you know, for the dog and cat and animal lovers out there, you know, different meaning to this one as well.
Oh, I have not seen that, but I can imagine that in my mind as being like a really nice montage, like a very happy, like you've got a big smile on your face watching it. Like
it is, yeah. It's a fun movie. Obviously, I have to see all these animated movies because, I mean, I've got kids right in that age, right? So not right. saying if you're not in that age, like don't necessarily go rush out and see it. But, you know, for amongst all the kid movie choices, that's a really good one.
Nice.
So, okay, next up, you said you take it in a different direction, and you do a little bit here, okay? This one is Pumpin' Blood by No No No.
Yeah, and you'd never really guess it from the title that this is, like, such a positive vibe thing, because it's got blood in the title, right? Like, that immediately might send you, you know, like, you'd be like, what? What am I about to listen to? But yeah, I mean, this has whistling, and I feel like any song that has whistling is like a happy song. I would be stretched to find a song that includes whistling that's angry whistling. I can't even imagine what that is like. You know, Rammstein isn't singing or whistling in his heavy metal songs.
That reminds me of Chris Rock's bit about, like, you can't look cool sipping on a straw.
Right, exactly.
Right? No matter how angry you are or whatever, if you pick up a drink and you start sucking out of a straw, like all of that is gone, like any intimidation.
I've seen that bit and it's priceless. Yeah, he's absolutely spot on. But yes, I love, you know, this is all about the heart, hence Pumpin' Blood. And it's like these lyrics, you know, this is your heart, it's alive, it's pumping blood, and it's your heart, it's alive. It's just got these great positive vibes lyric, you know, you're alive, like you're here, you're doing it, with this like great little whistling track behind it. And I just find myself again, kind of smiling, feeling good. It's a good reminder. Oftentimes the world can feel really crushing, especially recently. And so it's like nice to kind of like center yourself, come back to your breath, come back to your heartbeat, and remind yourself you're here. You can still do something, right? Like that is a gift. So that's why I love this song and why I want, you know, always think of it as like one of my joyful songs. It's nice to take that little moment and feel alive.
Totally agree with all that. Yeah, I had not heard of these guys, but I really like this song. And you're exactly right about the whistling, because this is a really cool rock song. And if you take the whistling out, it's just a rock song. But I think when you put the whistling in there, that's what gives it that joyful feel and kind of, you know, transforms it a little bit to where it fits this mix a little better.
Yeah, I agree with that. That's interesting. And I hadn't considered taking that out, but you're right. It would just be like a rock song. I like it.
Yeah, and still a good song, but yeah. I don't know if it fits this mix as well. Even though lyrically I think it fits as well, but I think it's the whistling that I think really got me, so loved it. All right, your third pick, you've got You and I by Crystal Fighters.
Yeah, I, you know, it's funny, I'd kind of honestly forgotten about this group. This is like a deep cut in my own library. I had listened to them many, many years ago, and as I started to dig around into some of my old playlists that were like kind of like happy mix or feel good or, you know, like whatever the many, many playlists I've accumulated over the years, this was on one of them. And I was like, oh, I do really like this song because it's got a fun vibe to it. It like kind of is dancey. It makes you, you know, want to like head bop and move. And I like the lyrics that it's like you and I, you know, it's all I need. I don't need anything else. Like that's kind of the theme of it. And so... yeah, I just like that idea, right? Like if you're lucky enough and you've got someone in your life and you feel it's like you and them against the world, like that can be a great gift. That can be a reason to smile no matter what's going on. So I just really like the song, and now it starts to kind of get thematic with the rest of my picks here. So it begins with this first pick of like you and I, and we're like against everything and we're feeling good. So that's, you'll see what happens here in a moment with that.
I really like this song. I had not heard these guys before, but the Spanish guitar, like kind of in this one, I thought really, really gave it a unique sound with the rest of it. And I thought it was just so well done. And yeah, like it's just a great, like you said, just really joyful song, just because you're kind of drifting to thoughts about your partner, right? And mm-hmm. It's great energy from the guitar and the drums, and I don't know. This one really stood out to me amongst all your picks, just because I think it was so unique sounding, just with the instruments and how they combined them. I thought it was really, really good.
Awesome. Yeah. Glad you liked it.
All right. Now, next was one I was a little bit more familiar with. This one is Praise You by Fatboy Slim.
Yes. So now that it's like you and I together, now it's time to praise you. Huh? See what I'm doing there? I think of this song as like my OG EDM song. I feel like this is like the first introduction to probably a lot of people of like EDM music. And like how that became a little bit more mainstream, because this got like a lot of radio play, which is not, you know, traditional. It's certainly back then for kind of a song of this genre, at least in my memory. Like, I feel like, you know, that wasn't the case. But yeah, like, love Fatboy Slim, love the song. I also remember this being played a lot at like middle school and high school dances in my growing up time period. You know, the local DJs loved that, but I just think it's a cool song. You know, it's, I actually think sometimes the lyrics, so I'm going to read these lyrics and then I'm going to tell you what I think about them. So the chorus is, we've come a long, long way together through the hard times and the good. I have to celebrate you, baby. I have to praise you like I should. And obviously this could be being sung to someone else, but I kind of like the idea that this could even be sung to like yourself, right? Like, take a moment to like praise yourself, have a conversation with yourself. We've come a long way. Like, you know, think about like everything that you've done and everything you've accomplished and like love yourself. Right. So I liked thinking about it that way for the first time in my life and realizing like this could be like a really cool kind of personal anthem song when taken in that perspective.
That's great. I really like that. Yeah. No, very good call. Yeah, this is a great song. Obviously it was a monster hit, I think, really big hit. And even better though, have you seen the music video? Are you familiar with it?
Not in a long time. I don't remember.
Okay. So it cost $800 to make. And it's okay. Directed by Spike Jonze and actually features Spike Jonze and this fictional dance troupe that he put together called the Torrance Community Dance Theater or something. Torrance Community Dance Troupe, something like that. And it seems like they're just out in front of this theater and doing this ridiculous, almost like flash mob type thing. It's hysterical.
Awesome.
Obviously led to Spike Jonze getting a lot more work with Fatboy Slim, and he worked with him on some other videos as well. But yeah, this one is so comical for just the look and feel of it. And that's going to put you in a good mood as well. It's going to put a smile on your face for sure.
I will definitely check that out. That sounds awesome.
All right, pick number five for you. You've got Millionaire by Cash Cash and Digital Farm Animals featuring Nelly.
So yeah, Cash Cash. Oh my goodness. This album in particular is one that I played all the time. And it was around the time that I was, you know, in spin instructing or about to get into spin instructing or whatever. But really, really fun EDM mix. This one is my all-time favorite off of that album, featuring Nelly's vocals here. And like kind of a fun story of She Must Be the Money was like, he like changed the lyric just enough from his song of Show Me the Money so that he wouldn't get like have to pay licensing fees for this track, or Cash Cash wouldn't, or whatever it is. It's pretty wild. But yeah, I love the lyrics of just like, you know, I feel like a millionaire kind of being repeated over and over. I think it's like it can put a smile on your face. That's obviously like a really popular phrase. Like you look like a million bucks. Like, you know, you feel like a millionaire. Like you've just got everything coming your way. You're full of like wealth and abundance, and you know, hopefully that brings you joy and good things. So I just really like the mood of this song and the vibe to it, and it always brings a smile to my face whenever I play it.
Yeah, this is a great one, and you're right, you know, Nelly harkens back here to his hit, I think it was Must Be the Money.
Yes.
Yeah. And like it was, so like that was kind of cool because it was almost like a new take on that song, you know, obviously different enough, but just kind of harkens back those feels. But I totally agree with what you just said, that hearing I Feel Like a Millionaire just over and over again, like they do in the song, I mean, that's just going to make you feel good. Even if you're not a millionaire, and most people aren't, okay?
Right, so, right.
Yeah, but yeah, just great energy with this one, and I love that. And it almost started to feel to me like a mantra, like that I Feel Like a Millionaire, like will really just kind of get you in a really good mood.
Yeah, absolutely. For some reason, I just thought of the character on the show Silicon Valley, Russ Han, like I'm blanking, was it Russ Hanneman or something?
Yeah.
The guy who wanted to
Free
be.
Commas.
He, Yeah, the Three Commas Club, right, Tres Comas. He would not be happy singing a song that he feels like a millionaire, because his whole thing was wanting to be a billionaire forever.
Yeah, that's true. He would call you a loser for just wanting to feel like a millionaire.
Right. So if you are one of the even fewer people that is a billionaire, maybe this song is beneath you. But for most other people, this is a very fun song to sing.
Yeah, that's a good question. Hey, if you're a billionaire, go ahead and reach out to us on Instagram. Okay, we'd love to hear from you.
Looking at you, Mark Cuban. You're like right in Matt's neighborhood. We watch you all the time on Shark Tank. You must listen to podcasts.
He must. Yeah. All right, your last pick. You've got Peanut Butter Jelly by Galantis.
Yeah, Galantis. Okay, so this song is like just happiness in a song for me. I can never play it and not immediately get into a good mood, at least while it's playing, because it is like just the most absurd song I think I've ever listened to date. The lyrics are completely nonsense, right? It's like the chorus is, spread it like peanut butter jelly, do it like I owe you some money. Like, I don't even know what that means.
I don't know what that means. Yeah.
It's impossible to know what that means. But the real fun thing is, you know, you just mentioned a music video a little while back. The music video to this one is also really fun because it just features a bunch of people walking around looking really grumpy and like suspicious in a grocery store. And then all of a sudden, you know, the beat hits, like the beat drops. And like their clothes fly off and they're wearing these amazing dance leotards and they just start dancing. And the people... The people look genuinely so happy. You know how, like, when people, like, really look happy, you can tell?
Yeah.
Like, these people dancing genuinely look so happy. So then you just can't help but just, like, feed off of their energy, even through watching this video, and you find yourself smiling. And it's so funny because, like, the comments all reflect that. Like, every single comment under the YouTube video is, like, how happy people are, how they keep coming back to the song when they need a pick-me-up. But my all-time favorite comment... is that someone had never, and I'm going to quote here, I'd never tried peanut butter jelly before, and to be honest, I'd never really heard of it either. But since this was released, I'm obsessed. I love it. Thank you, Galantis, for introducing me to my favorite sandwich.
Okay. First of all, there's no way that's true, but that's a funny comment.
I want to believe that it's true. I want to believe that someone... had never eaten a peanut butter jelly sandwich, which I think is probably common outside of the U.S. because I feel like it might not be as big of a sandwich outside the U.S. Either way, they'd never eaten one. They hear a song call it and they think, you know what? I'm going to try that.
That's amazing. And then
they have good results. So
they have good results.
That also brings me joy.
That is
about
their new favorite sandwich. That is kind of cool. Yeah. I'll give you that. When I saw this on the track listing, I thought it might be that Peanut Butter Jelly Time song that was like popular on the internet. And I was just kind of just, oh man, what are we doing here? Right. Like, this is not going to bring me joy. And then I got to this and I was like, oh, this is nothing like that song. This is great. It's got a real disco feel to it, I think. Mm-hmm. You know what? Disco music by and large puts you in a good mood, right? Like, it's kind of happy music. So, I like this one. I was not familiar with them, and now I definitely want to check out that music video.
Oh, it's so crazy. Yeah, we both have homework to do in terms of music videos to watch, but it's good stuff. All right, cool. Well, that was A side. So now we're going to take you over to the B side, flip the track, flip the cassette. And your first pick is Bang the Drum All Day by Todd Rundgren.
Yeah, this one's just great. It just kicks in right from the beginning, and it's just a lot of fun. It's about drumming. It's real straightforward, real simple, okay? Now, Samer, once upon a time in the early part of this century, okay, I was the public address announcer for Trinity University Volleyball, okay, small college here in Texas, and they were pretty good, and whenever they would win, I would play this song. This was like
nice.
The victory song. And prior to that, the match would just end, everyone, you know, cheer, and then we just walk away. But I just started playing this song, and at that point, it was probably about 20 years old, this song was. And, you know, now it's 40 years old. It still cooks. But, yeah, like, people started to get into it because once that final point was scored, I just cranked up this song. I didn't even wait.
I didn't even
announce anything. And people would just hang out to the end of this song. Like, so it started to catch on after a little while. But, that's what I remember about the song. But I just from the beginning, ever since I've known this song, I was like, this just puts me in a good mood. And I just love it.
Yeah, I love it too. I agree with you. Like, it starts to play, you feel happy from it playing. The lyrics are really fun. And honestly, now, because everything comes back to The Office, like that AJR song that we featured a little while back, I just now think of Michael banging on his coffee cup and, you know, singing like his version of it. Like, I don't want to work. I just want to bang on my mug all day.
Yeah, even Michael Scott. It'll put Michael Scott in a good mood.
Exactly. Yeah. Yeah. So, yes, I love the beat of the song, and I can 100% relate to the lyrics, because there are many days that I don't want to work and I would rather probably beat on a drum all day.
Sure.
You know?
Yeah.
So, nice one. Good opening pick. All right. Your next one, so our track 8 overall, is Happy Birthday by Stevie Wonder.
Okay, so when we did our covers mix last year, we did, I think we featured We Can Work It Out, okay, the Beatles original version, and then Stevie Wonder's version, which I think we agreed on that show was just so much better than
superior.
The Beatles, right?
Yeah. So much better. Yep.
Okay, so once again, we have the Beatles, and this still gets played, the You Say It's Your Birthday song, right? Okay, not a bad song, but gets a ton of radio play. Stevie Wonder's Happy Birthday song is like 1,000 times better. Then they say it's your birthday.
Yeah.
So once again, Stevie Wonder kind of just sticking it to the Beatles, I feel like.
He's 2-0 against them.
Yeah.
So.
And just far superior than just your standard happy birthday song, too. Like just the regular happy birthday song. Yeah. I mean, first of all, happy birthday. You know, you could think of anybody's birthday and it's going to put you in a good mood. But man, Stevie's version here, I just love it.
Hey, do you like music?
Yeah.
Do you like comedy?
Sure do.
Do you like games?
Absolutely.
Then why not come check out the Hook and Bridge podcast?
What are you waiting for?
The number one brother and sister music comedy podcast, located on all of your favorite podcast streaming networks. That's the Hook and Bridge podcast, now streaming on Spotify and Amazon Music.
I agree. It's really good. I didn't realize this, but this is actually like a song about MLK's birthday. And it was like his big push to have MLK Day become MLK Day, which is Martin Luther King's birthday. And that was like kind of the background of why he wrote this song. And I think obviously a lot of people are familiar with the chorus where he's singing literally like happy birthday. But I didn't know that background because I'd never paid too much attention to the lyrics outside of the happy birthday part. So I thought that was really interesting. You know, all the other words sung in this song, I just kind of glossed over.
Yeah, it may not have been as effective as Stevie had hoped for. You know, people just playing it on their birthdays and celebrating themselves, you know.
And he's like, no, everyone, it's about MLK.
I'm trying to make a political point here, people. Come on.
All right. Yeah. It did eventually get signed into law as a national holiday in 1986 by, at the time, President Reagan. So, you know, I guess maybe the song did work.
Yeah.
It, you know, that's great. But I agree. It's a really great song. It's got the mood for it, you know, to be on this mix. And it's like, again, kind of hard to listen to it and not feel happy. So it's really nice. And it's got a good story to it, too, because it was successful in his intent. So... good for you, Stevie Wonder. Good for you. All right. So track 9, you went with Cut to the Feeling by Carly Rae Jepsen.
Okay. So Carly Rae Jepsen, not usually on my playlist. Okay.
Yeah.
There's an animated movie out there called Leap, which, again, I doubt you've seen. Okay. I've watched it a million times because my daughter loves it. But it's a pretty underrated animated movie. It's actually pretty good, pretty entertaining. It's about a little girl who gets out of an orphanage in France and decides to go to a dance school. All right. I'm not going to spoil the ending, but, you know, it's a happy ending. I'll just leave it at that.
Sure.
The notable voices of the characters in the song are Elle Fanning and Carly Rae Jepsen, right? Like, so they both play characters in this movie. And Carly Rae Jepsen, like after this like happy ending, this song kicks in at the very end. So you've got the happy ending, but you've also got this song starting right then. And this song also just puts me in a good mood, even though it's not written for me, totally out of the demographic, right? It's just a total kind of, you know, almost like teen pop song in a way. But it's just a really happy, fun song.
I agree. I wrote that this got me moving and vibing and smiling. like it definitely is. It checks all those boxes. And you know, it's funny. I was really tempted to put Katy Perry's Firework because that's like another song that just makes me feel like, you know, in that crossover of like fired up slash happy.
Yeah.
And I think like this is kind of a good substitute for not having Katy Perry on this mix. Like this kind of falls in that category of a strong, you know, female pop voice, making you feel good and making you just want to like take on the world. So, and I especially love the lyrics here, like cancel your reservations, no more hesitations. This is on, can't make it stop. Give me all you got. I want it all or nothing. So I definitely like that attitude of just like going out and like, yeah, this is happening and you feel really good and happy. So I liked it. It was a good pick.
Yeah. And I also like featuring a song like this that, I don't know, I never hear this on the radio. Like, I've only heard this in that movie. So it's like, contrast to Firework, this might be one that people haven't heard of that they can get into.
Yeah, totally. All right. Well, I'm guessing a lot of people have heard this next pick because it is just one of the most classic introductions to a song ever. And I mean, I kind of want to start singing it right here. But you went with September by Earth, Wind, and Fire.
Yeah, I love this song. I never get tired of it, even though you're right, like it just plays all the time. But from the second I hear those first few notes, right, I'm like, oh, here we go. Okay,
yes.
And then there's so much energy, and Maurice White, he's got that high voice, and he's singing, and everybody could sing along to this. So great wedding song, right? If you're making a wedding mix, all right, and maybe you're going to make a mixtape card with Super Awesome Mix, you might want to include September on it. But yeah, I mean, it's funny because they asked Maurice White why he mentions the 21st of September. And he said it just sang well. But then his wife claims that it was the due date of their son. And that's why he mentions the 21st of September. So maybe he didn't want to give that away, but his wife mentions it. So, but
that's
yeah,
so funny.
Just a really great, energetic, kind of fun song.
It is, yeah. It has, again, like just that amazing intro. You get immediately kind of like perked up to it. There's also a really funny TikTok meme going around with like the beginning of that, of this song, but then rather than the real song kicking in, someone playing like a horrible rendition, I think on a recorder. And so it's like used for a lot of great memes of like you set out to do something, but then it's just awful. It's so great. So that brings me a lot of joy. I've listened to that so many times scrolling through like TikTok and Instagram reels that I almost expected this to be that. And I was like, right, no, it's a real song. I have to remind myself that. But yeah, great pick. I also really got a kick out of reading about the 21st of September. And the songwriter actually said, I learned my greatest lesson in songwriting. Never let the lyric get in the way of the groove. So sorry. And he sang sorry in reflection of the fact that it was just like a good like date to use for the song. All right. Well, your last two picks, we've got track 11 here on the mix. Queen making another appearance. Never upset about that. You've got Don't Stop Me Now.
Yeah. As far as songs that just put me in a good mood, I mean, this is absolutely one of them. Okay. Don't Stop Me Now. It's interesting reading up on the song because it's almost like Freddie Mercury was just kind of telling everyone how much fun he's having being like just as famous as he is. And Brian May has said that he actually kind of doesn't like the song because Freddie was doing a lot of things that were kind of harmful to himself. Right. So that's a little bit of history on it. But look, just on the surface, you listen to the song, you're going to be in a good mood.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, I really love that, like the fast paced, like frenetic beat of this song. It does make you just kind of want to like get moving and like feel good and jump out of bed. I feel like this would make like a really good song. I've been kind of working on a playlist of music I want to listen to like right out of bed to where I'm going to be in a good mood for the next like couple of hours in the morning. Right.
Yeah,
like,
yeah.
And I feel like this would be an amazing one. Like I could see myself wanting to like, you know, go make coffee and maybe even go for a walk a little bit earlier than normal. You know, whatever that is, like I'm gonna just keep on moving and you can't stop me because I'm having a good time.
I think it's perfect too, after you've accomplished something, to get you going on the next thing, right? Like, nice. Kind of keep the momentum going a little bit too. Keep you in that great mood.
I like it. All right. Track 12. So you went with a song that I was so happy to see on here because I think it is such a sleeper hit on this album. It is so good. White Walls featuring Schoolboy Q and Hollis by Macklemore and Ryan Lewis.
Yeah, so I think I've talked to you about this before because you're a big Macklemore fan. And every time I listen to him, I'm like, oh, this is a great song. Oh, this is a great song. So I'm like, all right, I'm just going to start listening to Macklemore more because I keep saying this is a really good song. That's a really good song. So,
right.
Like this was one that I keep going back to amongst his songs because I just love, it's got a real, like, not only does it put you in a good mood, but it's also kind of has a mellow feel to it, almost like I talked about with Lovely Day with Bill Withers. So this was like maybe the perfect beginning and end to this mix because, you know, it's just got a great vibe, but it's also a really cool vibe. So it's kind of like end of your day, right? Like you've gotten a lot done, you're feeling pretty good, or maybe you're not feeling as good, but you could drive home, listen to this, and you're going to be in a good mood when you hit the door.
Yeah. Oh my goodness. Absolutely. This was like one of my favorite songs to listen to in my car. And obviously it's like so well suited for that, right? Like you get in your car, you roll the windows down, you can just be like, you don't need to be driving fast in it. Like you're just playing this. Macklemore's lyrics, again, like we've talked about, are just always so clever and funny. And I just love the idea of him owning this like old Cadillac that he just absolutely loves. And I love the lyrics, you know, I got that off black Cadillac midnight drive, got that gas pedal leaning back, taking my time, rolling that roof off, letting in the sky, I shine, the city never looks so bright. So yeah, you're just like, you're vibing, you know, you're just in your car that you love and you're having a good time. And I agree with you. It's like got that mellow beat, but like a very positive mellow beat. You're not going to feel sad listening to this one for sure. So I liked it a lot. I'm so happy to see this, and I thought that was such a great pick. Nice job.
Nice. All right. Well, there you have it, okay? If you weren't in a good mood at the start of this podcast, you have to be by now, because I was in a great mood listening to all these songs. So there you go. A really happy, super awesome mix for your collection, and we're going to put up that Instagram poll so you can let us know which one puts you in a better mood. Hopefully they both put you in a good mood, side A and side B.
I like that.
Yeah. So
yeah, I like that.
Yeah. But which mood were even better? So hopefully I can compete a little better this time than I did in the workout mix. I don't know. I'm going to keep my fingers crossed. All right. all right. But there you go. We're going to keep working on more super awesome mixes for your collection. So for Samrat, this is Matt, and we'll see you next time. Super Awesome Mix is brought to you by DLM. Make shopping easy with DLM, the one-stop shop for all your casual clothing needs. Shop DLMSupplyCo.com and enter the promo code AWESOME at checkout to save 15% off your first purchase. That's DLMSupplyCo.com.